Hello? Where are you?
You again.
Anyway, what's up, dudes? Welcome back to another episode of the ElCamino Build. Before I get started, I just wanted to say real quick that I got some constructive criticism, which I truly appreciate from you guys. So what they said was that with me being that little clip in the corner, like the game channels do and stuff like that, because I seem to talk very much with my hands and stuff, it's kind of distracting. So there's going to be a lot less of this and a lot more of this. So jumping right back into where we took off from last time in the ElCamino build, I was working on that back bumper, getting it all lined up, getting it squared off so it would fit nice. So now that everything's kind of set where it needs to be, it's time to lock that sucker down. That's the first thing I'm going to attack in this video. And as you're going to see, I just use those bar stools that I had. They're adjustable. There's a little lever on the side. You can grab them, slide them up and down. So that I was able to get my proper height, proper angle. And of course, you can never be too safe, so you want to measure as much as you can before you make anything solid and put anything down. I got to take the bar off the back. I got my little shop helper with me, helping me out as always. So I got to take the bar off the back. That bar was initially put there just so that when I welded the whole thing that it would stay kind of squared. Now that it's going in the truck, I don't need that bar, and it's going to be tough to cut that thing off when it's on the back of the frame. So I just went ahead and did it right away. Now it pulled in a little bit because of the bars and the weld and the way it was, but it was pretty simple just to pull it back out as I was welding it on, try to center it in the center of that frame piece where I was putting it. There you can see I was using the angle finder, the leveler, to make sure that everything was lined up because I wanted that back of that tube to go straight in line with the chassis so that it looks uniform, straight, good, and everything is not a problem. While I was in there, I had to weld up the bars for the diff brace and stuff like that, make sure it was all good and solid, because in this video we're putting the back half of the roll cage on it. Now once that back half is on the roll cage, it's going to be pretty impossible for me to jump around in there because I'm not tiny. So getting that done right away was probably a solid move. Oh yeah, right here. Don't do that. I just had that can next to the grinder. I didn't blow up, but I could have. Like, nope. Don't be dumb like me. So dangerously cutting again next to that brake cleaner bottle. Now the brake cleaner, I have it right next to the piping because when you get these piping, when you order it, there's always like a weird coating on it to prevent it from rusting. And so I just use that to clean it off and mark the spot where I'm going to cut because it's an oil. And then when you put your marker on top of that kind of oil that protects it, it doesn't mark very good and you can't always see exactly where you wanted to put your line to cut. So I would advise totally cleaning off with brake cleaner. Just make sure you move the can away from yourself before you start grinding with open sparks or start welding an open flame or whatever. You could die. Going on with the standard, measured 100 times, cut once, hopefully. Here I'm measuring the bars for the back. Now it's pretty tricky to measure the bar for the back because I want to throw a bend in it. And I don't really have a method of measuring that bend except for like a cheater bar that I had previously. Now what a cheater bar is, for the bends, basically what I have is a piece that's bent to as much as a bender can do, and you use that to kind of gauge where you need to put your next bends, your angles and whatever, and see if it'll fit somewhere. So I had to use that and then measure the rest of the pipe to get somewhere close to where I needed to be. But at the same time, I wanted to make sure that I had a lot of excess material on it, because if it wasn't right, it's easier to cut stuff off and you can't really add on, because it's a roll cage pipe. It needs to be one solid piece as much as possible. Like, the more one solid bars you have in there, the stronger it's gonna be. So I had to make sure there's enough left over on the ends that when I bent it, I would have still the same distance and I would have room to chop stuff off, because as soon as it's on and it's kind of in place, I'm gonna have to cut it to do like throat line bends. But because this is on a cage that's gonna be met up at a point where there's like four different bars connecting to from the main hoop behind the cage, and then I got the roof bars going in, I had to leave myself a little bit of room because I knew I was going to have to kind of cut a crazy weird sort of design on the end of it that would make it butt up to the rest of the pipes really good so that you can weld it and make it solid. So now I'm just going to bend the pipes, bend the ends of them so I can get the angle, and then I'll start working on the length from there. So on these benders, you can see I'm putting on a clamp there. Very important. if you don't bolt that down tight, you could just slide the pipe in, put the little clamp on, and slide the bolt through like a pin, and you'd almost think it's good. But for some reason, no matter what you do, when you start cranking on that thing, it's gonna break itself loose. So make sure you put down that clamp real tight. I probably mentioned that in a previous video, but it's a definite, you have to do that. This pipe bender, it's a mandrel bender. It doesn't kink the tubing when it bends. It stretches it, it makes it strong. It's what's required for the FD rule book. FD is Formula Drift. If you guys don't know, that's the world's biggest drift competition, basically. So I follow the rule book on that to have a good guideline. If ever I go anywhere, I might be in spec a little bit. I know this car is not going to be legal for competition whatsoever, but not a super huge concern of mine. The car's meant to be having fun. So here I'm doing the second set of piping. Now it's pretty tricky to get the angles exactly. So as you can see, I keep going back with the angle finder and checking every few times I bend. That's because I want to make sure that I don't go over the angle. Going under, you can sometimes get the pipe back in the bender, but if you go over, you're kind of in trouble there. Mashed up the two pieces on the floor, everything fits good. So I got both the exact same bend, the same angle, which is perfect. It's good for what I'm trying to do. Now we got to test fit these suckers in there and see how much I'm going to have to take off the tops. Because like I mentioned before, and you'll be able to see it a little bit where I'm putting the roll cage in through the back window, but there's a couple pipes that line up to that spot, and I had to make sure that it's going to fit on it really good, a nice solid fitment, nice, no big gaps so that it can be welded good. Strength is pretty much what you're going for here. Now that everything is cut and measured and I've got an idea of the size, I'm just gonna throw it back into the clamp into the bench vise. And then start cutting everything to length, and then start cutting the throat lines and making all the little angles I need whatsoever. You know what I mean? Sorry guys, kind of babbling here, but this is a part where basically it's a lot of like test fit, cut, back and forth, while trying to make everything exactly the same length and the same size. Here you can see I'm doing that infamous throat cut again, which I talked about in previous videos. If you haven't seen it, go check out the video before this and the video before that. There's a pretty good description on how to do this and what its purpose is. And basically, this is a cheat for not having a pipe notcher. Now I have one now, which I fortunately got for my birthday this year, but I was already done all the roll cage work at that point. So that just means if you're going to keep watching this channel, you know that we're going to have to do something else with the roll cage in it, just so I can get to use these tools I got, these new toys and stuff. Now that I'm welding everything in, I've got a pretty good idea where it's going. It's starting to look good. It was a tricky part to actually line up where the pipe, this cage was going to fall in, because I didn't want it too far back, because I didn't want it looking like it was some sort of safari vehicle with like a cage that you're going to put animals in the back. And I didn't want it too far forward because it would look kind of weak maybe a little bit. I was worried about, I could almost drop them straight out the back window right to where the axle is, but I found that made it really shallow. And this way, with the cage going all the way to the back, number one, I think it's going to be more rigid, because now the whole chassis of the truck is one big arcing triangle, basically. And the other reason for having them so high up so far back, because as you can see, they basically all run up to the back bumper. So I wanted enough room to clear my fuel cell and my radiator to offer some sort of protection to all that. And that you're going to see in the next video, in an upcoming video. So thanks so much for watching, dudes. Peace out. Stick around.